Hi there!
Hello.
Hi, this is Pablo and Anne from Tango Space, where we help men and women in London and in Paris to move better, express themselves, be creative, and meet friendly people with our tango lessons. In this video, we want to tell you about the tango cross and how to do the tango cross. It is one of the most emblematic movements of tango, with a woman crossing her legs. You will see it's very beautiful. And it is also a movement that we use a lot to change directions in our dancing.
The cross is a very important movement that we use a lot in tango. And yes, it becomes part of the walk. It's something that we use all the time. When the leader is walking outside of the woman and is inviting her to cross, and we are going to do this in different dynamics with different different type of orchestras, different ways. So it's a very, very useful moment. Now we are going to show you how we do the cross, and we are going to show you first in the practice and break. Yes? So we start together taking a side step together. This step is always bigger for the leader. The leader is taking a slightly bigger step by keeping the woman on the right side. So with my shoulders, I face this side. So in that way, I might have to do a smaller step. And then I'm going to take a forward step outside of her with my right leg. This is very important for the leader because it's a very common mistake here to go away. Yes, if you go with the hips up, you start stepping a bit outside, and then you will lose your partner after the cross. So what we need to do is to go with the knee and to find the space to land next to her foot. Yeah? We are very, very close, keeping our line.
And ladies, we give them the time, so we stop. We wait, and then when we feel that they have almost touched our foot, so that means they are ready, we know that we are going to keep walking.
So here I'm going to take one step, two steps, and now I'm going to invite her to the cross. So with my center, I will bring my chest forward again, and I will invite her to cross. I collect, I change my weight, I change her weight, and then we resolve together.
Three things for the ladies. The first is, how do we cross? So when we are crossing, we put our knee is going to go in front of the other knee. So it's the left knee goes in front of the right knee, and we have our toes next to the other toes. So we are not crossing here, we're not crossing there either. We have our feet as close to each other as possible, and it's really the knees that are crossing. The second thing that is very important is to make sure that our hips are in front of the man. So when he's doing the cross, here I keep my hips in front of his hips. I don't go here, okay? I stay there. And the third thing is that I cross, I stay on my right leg, and then he invites me to change my weight, then I go to my left leg, and then I can keep walking with my right leg.
So, for the leaders, to lead the cross very, very clear, we need three things. Yes? Three important things that we need to remember is that we are leading a circular movement with the center. So, when you are walking outside, yes, your center is facing her. So, when your center goes forward, is when she's going to go in front of you. That's the first thing. The circular movement from the center. The second thing that we need to remember is that we need to give the space to help to the cross. How I create the space is by leaving my leg behind. So here I go one, two, and here I leave my leg behind. I invite her to go into the cross, and then I collect after her. Yes? That's very important. Because if you don't leave the space, probably she will not cross, she will continue the walk. And the third thing is the time, because we need to change the dynamic. So if we are walking in the cross, we slow down to lead the cross and then continue. If you keep the same dynamic as you were walking, she will not cross because she will not have the time. So remember these three things, yes?
So ladies, one little tip for you is that when the man is walking outside of you, it means that he's very likely to do the cross. He's probably preparing for that. So that means that we can anticipate and help him by creating space for us. How I do that is that I take a bigger back step. I will show you now. We will show you now. So, he's walking outside of me, probably to the cross. I will do a bigger side step. And you saw, I did a back step. I did a bigger back step on my second back step. And that gave me more space to do my cross. So we were showing to you in practice embrace, which is how we practice. But now when you want to dance it, obviously it is in the tango close embrace. So in the close embrace, nothing changes in the embrace while we are doing the cross. So we will show you now, we go into the close embrace, we will do the cross, and we invite you to do the same, and nothing happens in the embrace, it stays relaxed, calm, and always the same.
Remember that the cross is we can use a lot in tango, and it's very playful. You can do the cross slow, big, small, fast. You can play a lot with the cross.
It's very fun.
And it becomes part of the walk. Yes, so it's something that we use all the time because it's part of the walk. It's something that we always use.
Yeah. So use it to challenge yourself and play with your partner. So we really hope that this video helped you. If it does and if you liked it, please like it and share it with your friends. If you're on Facebook, you can like our page. On YouTube, you can also subscribe to our channel to receive weekly video tips. And especially,
please keep learning and keep sharing your dancing, because the world of tango needs your embrace.
Yes, definitely. We look forward to seeing you in the next video.
Bye-bye.
Now, if you enjoyed this and want to learn more, even more, about dancing the tango fundamentals beautifully, if you want to feel confident in your dancing, go check our free online tango course, Tango Boost. It's a phenomenal email course that teaches you everything you need to know about connection, the embrace, the different styles, the codes, the history of tango, and it also gives you an understanding of the tango music, so you can start enjoying it straight away. So if you are a tango addict, or if you are just starting out on your tango journey, it is the perfect course to boost your dancing. And what's more, it's free. To sign up, it is very easy. You simply need to go onto our website, tangospace.com, fill up your details, and then you will start receiving our teaching straight away. We hope it is helpful, and we look forward to seeing you there.